Is everybody doing all right? Okay. Well, I want to talk to you about some things that we all need to look inside of our hearts. You think you know what it is? I mean, know what the word reputation means? Do you know what the word character means? And what about integrity? Do they all go together? They actually are all three completely different things. So your reputation is what people think they know about you. What they think you stand for. Key word being think. Why would I say think? Because your reputation might not be who you actually are. And that's what your character is who you actually are. How you act. Okay? But integrity is also about how you act. So they're a little same. But your character might be funny. Might be a snazzy dresser. Might be known to hang around the wrong people and then you get called a shady character. So, you know, character can be many different things. So what is integrity? So we have reputation, which is, what did I just say? What people think you are. You might have a great reputation for being a great artist or a great singer, or you have the best business around that's known for whatever it is. You have a construction business. You might be the best poet. That's what your reputation might be. You have a business, right? So hopefully his reputation in the Basin area means he is the best financial guy alive. Your finances, right? So how does that fit with integrity? How many here think they have integrity? So what do you think the definition of integrity is? Integrity, like character, similar, is how you act. But it's not just how you act in public. It's how you act all the time. It's how you act when nobody's looking. It's what you do when nobody's around. So does your reputation match your character? And does your character match your integrity? What does that mean? What's it mean? Integrity is what you do when no one's looking. Character is how you behave. When somebody's not acting right, you say, that's just not in character. That's not what they do. You might be known for being on time, a great worker. That's part of being your character. So I'm going to take it to a marriage. Husband and wife been married for several years. A friend of the husband comes up to him and he says, your wife's had an affair with me. I'm telling you, I witnessed it. I saw her in the act. He says, no, not my wife. So he believes that her reputation and her character and her integrity are completely aligned. A few months later, the truth comes out, because the truth usually does. Matter of fact, I'm writing a book now. It's going to be out very soon called When the Truth Hunts You Down. And it's powerful. It's just about the truth coming out. So when that happens, his friend and his relationship became fractured because he didn't believe him. It turned out that the friend was actually telling the truth. And the wife's character, integrity, and reputation were, in fact, not who she was pretending to be. How many of us pretend to be something that we're not? How many of us pretend to know people and do things with people that we actually don't? We drop names because it makes us feel better. It makes us feel important. So when you have two of the three that align, you're going to see good things happen, okay? You're going to see happiness. You're going to start to see some success. The problem with that is it's going to be short-lived. How can you say that? Because you're doing what people think they want from you. You're acting a way that you really aren't. So they're not all three aligning. But when you have all three of those characters, integrity, reputation that align, miracles can happen. Because now, you don't have to worry about what anybody else is going to say or do about you. Because you know what you stand for. You're standing for it. You're acting like it. And you're showing up to do it. So how many of you guys can say you are the same at work as you are at home? I hope you can. How many of you guys can say you are the same at home as you are at church? A lot of us try to pretend that we're going to be on our best behavior at church. Why? Why do we do that? Why are we on our best behavior at church? Because have a congregation full of people that are on their best behavior trying to impress you, that's not friendship. But when you have integrity, you have the character that matches that. Not only the character that matches that, but the reputation too. Now what people think about you matches your actions and matches who you really are. So we need to look deep inside ourselves for that. I do conventions and events for a living. That's what I do. And one of the things we stress is how to become the better person. So the events are called Becoming the Best You. This year, the theme of that Becoming the Best You is overcoming challenges. So my challenge to you tonight is to make sure that all three of those align. Because when they align, what happens? That's right. You're already great. So let's just get greater. Let's be awesome. And then let's take it to the next level and help others to do the same thing. So my pleasure.